गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट केमिकल चेंजेस. वन केमिकल चेंज ऑलरेडी आई हैव डिस्कस्ड, दैट इज रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन. अनदर वन इज ब्राउनिंग ऑफ वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट्स. दिस इज ऑल्सो अ केमिकल चेंज, ब्राउनिंग ऑफ वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट्स. चिल्ड्रन, यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड your when your mother cuts brinjal, she soaks that brinjal pieces in bowl of water. Why so, children? Because one thing you can do next time when your mother cuts this brinjal, you take 2-3 pieces and keep on a plate. Okay, after some time you will find that the browning has taken place. Why this browning has taken place, children? Because in the brinjal there is a chemical called polyphenol oxidase. Okay, which chemical is there? Polyphenol oxidase. When it comes in contact of air, okay, it forms air plus this polyphenol oxidase forms a brown color pigment called melanin. Brown colored pigment called melanin. So because of this brown color pigment, the surface of brinjal becomes brown. Okay, to protect from browning, that is why your mother soaks when she cut brinjal in water. Same manner in the case of apple, children. When we cut the apple, what happens after few minutes, like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, the surfaces of cut apple become brown. Okay. Now next chemical reaction is reaction between vinegar. Reaction between vinegar and baking soda. Vinegar and baking soda. Children, this reaction is very common. You must have done the volcanic activity. You have made volcanoes. So in volcanoes, we use these thing for the eruption of volcano. We use this to make the project of volcano. So what is vinegar? Vinegar is acetic acid. This is very mild acid. Mild means not harmful. We use to eat it also. Like we use as when we make any dish, we add this vinegar. Okay. So this is acetic acid vinegar. When it reacts with baking soda. Baking soda. What is the formula of baking soda? NaHCO3. This is sodium, this is hydrogen, this is carbonate. Okay, and here CH3COOH. This is what? Vinegar. This is baking soda. When they react, children, you can do this experiment in home. You ask your mother baking soda and add 1 spoon of vinegar in that. You will find the bubbles will come out. What are these bubbles? These bubbles are nothing else carbon dioxide gas. So what after the reaction between baking soda and sodium, this baking soda and vinegar, what will take place? Sodium acetate will form, CH3COONa. This is sodium and this is acetate. What are we going to call this chemical? Sodium acetate and carbon dioxide plus water. So what three things would be formed when vinegar and baking soda we are going to react? These are reactant, these are product. What products are there? Sodium acetate, carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide, it comes out in the form of bubbles. Why? Because this is a gas. And children, we make arrow for gas. Okay, this gas goes up. So in the form of bubbles, we can see this gas. And one more thing, children, science asks that you prove everything. So proving this, that the carbon dioxide is coming out, what we will do? We will pass this carbon dioxide gas in lime water. What is the formula of lime water? This is calcium hydroxide. This is lime water and chemical name is calcium hydroxide. This portion is called hydroxide. This is calcium. Okay. When carbon dioxide we pass, this is a gas, this is liquid. When we pass this gas in calcium hydroxide, what happened? This calcium hydroxide and carbon together will form calcium carbonate and water. What two things would be formed? Calcium carbonate and water. What is calcium carbonate? Calcium carbonate is lime powder. You have seen in India. Carbon dioxide when react with calcium hydroxide, it gives calcium carbonate and water. Calcium carbonate is white powder and it makes the solution milky. Okay, so what we say, when we pass carbon dioxide gas in calcium hydroxide, that turns milky. Okay, now the third one is reaction between, not third one, that is fourth one, reaction between copper sulfate and iron. Okay, children, copper sulfate, this is the formula of copper sulfate, and iron is this. What happened here, the most important thing is reactivity of metal. Children, there are many metals and we have arranged the metals according to their reaction with other things. Okay, so we call that reactivity series, and in class 8 you will learn about reactivity series. Okay, so here this is the experiment I am going to show you. We will take a beaker. This copper sulfate is blue in color, blue crystal. When we dissolve blue color crystal, we get the blue color solution in it. Okay, blue color solution. What happened when we are going to keep 2-3 nails of iron? Okay, iron nails when we are going to keep in this, and we are going to leave it for a day. Next day we will find the reaction has taken place. Iron from the nails come out. Iron from the nails, they have come out. They have replaced copper. They have replaced copper. Okay. Because iron is more reactive than copper. Both are metals. Iron is more reactive than copper. So it has removed copper from copper sulfate and forms iron sulfate. And copper comes out. This copper we can see deposited on the nail. Brown color layer is deposited on nail. That is what? Free copper. And the solution from blue turned green. You can see in your book, the solution turned green from blue because of the formation of iron sulfate. Children, one more activity we will do related with this. And this is also called displacement reaction. Why? Iron displaces copper. That is why we also call it displacement reaction. Now, we are going to do activity. In this activity, we will take 3 test tubes. Okay? 3 test tubes. 1. 2 and 3. And the same solution we will make copper sulfate and we will fill in this. 10 ml copper sulfate solution we are going to pour in all these test tubes. Okay. Now, in first one we are going to keep the zinc metal. In second, magnesium. And in third, iron. Okay, children? Now, we will find when copper sulfate react with zinc, when copper sulfate react with magnesium. This is zinc, this is magnesium ribbon, this is iron ribbon. Okay? We are going to keep it for a day. We will find when copper sulfate react with zinc, here the blue solution turned transparent, like clear solution, no color is there. So what happened? It has formed zinc sulfate, it has removed copper, zinc has removed copper because zinc is more stronger than copper. So it has removed copper and what has formed? Zinc sulfate plus copper. This copper we can find deposited on the zinc. Same manner here, the solution turned color is there, clear solution. So it has formed magnesium sulfate. What it shows that zinc sulfate and magnesium sulfate, they have no color. Okay. And what comes out? Copper. Copper. Okay. This copper we will find deposited on zinc, this magnesium ribbon. Third, iron. Already you have seen that iron sulfate is formed. And what is the color of iron sulfate? Green. Okay. Green color, iron sulfate, green color is there and copper is formed. Copper we can find deposited on the nail. Okay, children? So, that this is it. Reaction between copper sulfate and iron nails. And this reaction is also called displacement reaction. In all the cases you are seeing that copper is displaced by a strong metal. Okay, children? Thank you.